Hey everyone, I am here with Liz Johnson. And Liz and I have had the pleasure of knowing each other for a few months now, and I've had the experience to learn just how impactful she can be with brands. And a little bit about her is Liz is the president and principal consultant of Mountain View Marketing. She has an incredible 44 years of experience in branding, marketing, advertising, PR, and an additional 19 years of experience with website and social media, which is just a lot of years. So Liz has had the ability to build and leverage a lot of engaging and effective brands, and she's grown businesses of all sizes in countless verticals across the United States. So I'm really excited to chat with her today, and I brought her in specifically to talk about what is your brand and what is the role of your brand, because I think this is a really impactful conversation to be having and really can get your gears turning. So I'm going to hand it over to Liz to kind of start in talking about like what is your brand and what does that mean?
Thank you, Carrington. It's a pleasure to be here today. It's important to understand what your brand is. Your brand is your known identity as a company. It's the essence of what your company stands for. It's what your clients, prospective clients, colleagues, referral partners, and business organizations think of when they hear your brand name. It's your promise to your clients regarding what you provide and the value of it to them. Your brand is what drives your clients to want your services or products instead of just need those services or products. And your brand is what connects you emotionally with your clients and with your prospective clients. So your brand plays an extremely important role in the growth and vibrant future of your business.
Yeah, those are huge. And I feel like a lot of people jump in and maybe they start their business and then thinking about like what is my brand ends up coming as a later component, right? And like now I got to start honing in on this. How do you help people who have been in those kind of situations where like they've already started and now they need to figure that part out because they realize they hadn't done it yet?
Well, it's important to do it correctly. You should build your brand first and then leverage it. But a lot of startups, just push out into the marketplace and then try to figure it out. What we do is what we call a brand assessment. We look at their current brand that they have rolled out. Is it effective? Is it engaging? Is it consistent? Is it the right color palette for their business to maximize and optimize their results? Are they using the right font? Is the tagline most effective? Your tagline should be 5 words or less. So we analyze all of these things. We look at their value propositions, their final value propositions or unique brand assets, and determine if, in fact, the brand that they have rolled out is reflective visually and verbally of their final value propositions or unique brand assets. And then, if changes need to be made, then we can help them make them. But it's important to assess your brand because it determines the future and the success of your business.
That is definitely huge for people. And I feel like sometimes people get too like caught up in like what they like, right? Or what might resonate with them. How do you help people maybe realize I'm like, all right, part of it can be about you, but there's also a lot of other people who are the people that you really want to benefit, right? How do you figure out like that happy medium right there?
Well, if your brand doesn't resonate with your target markets, your primary and secondary target markets, it doesn't matter if you like it or you don't. What's really critical is it has to be reflective of your company, but it has to be created strategically so that it does engage and resonate with your target markets. I've been following the subliminal analysis of color in branding for 12 years. I've got probably 1,500 pages of studies in my office. There is a tremendous difference in choosing the right colors for your brand, for your ideal target markets, and the wrong colors.
Are
The
there
font is critical. If you have a traditional law firm that's been in business for 100 years, then maybe Times Roman is a good font for your branding. You know, it says tradition, established. If, however, you're a leading edge company, a serif font like that is a huge mistake. You need something that's sans serif. An example would be Calibri. So you want to make sure that your brand visually and verbally resonates and engages with your target market and fuels your business growth, both vibrantly and sustainably.
Are there any certain colors you usually tell people to stay away from or that are maybe oversaturated in certain markets?
It depends on your type of business and the target market you're trying to reach. I can tell you that blue is the most popular branding color, and subliminally, blue conveys expertise, authority, knowledge, and many other attributes. And statistically, it's been proven to cultivate client loyalty.
Mm-hmm.
So many businesses use blue.
Right.
Red is an action color. Dark green is great for banks and financial institutions. Light green is great for health products and natural products and things like that. It's very scientific.
Mm-hmm. That's awesome. Are there any like main questions people should ask when they're trying to pick out their colors, when they're thinking about it, that can really help them narrow it down?
Well, to be really effective with determining your ideal colors in branding and which shades, which PMS shades are more effective, there's a lot of science to that. That's tough for someone to do. They can do a lot of research and get most of that information, but you need to be very careful that you look at the colors you're choosing, what they represent subliminally, and are those attributes going to resonate with your ideal target markets?
Mm-hmm.
Because if they don't, whether you like them or not, it's not very valuable to you.
Right. That's awesome. So for somebody who's really starting to hone in on all of this, are there any few tips and tricks you would give somebody to say like, hey, this is where you can start to really get that leading edge going?
Well, you need to determine your business. You know, is it more traditionally based than a serif font like Times Roman? I'm just giving an example, would be a good choice. If your business is progressive, then you want a sans serif font. You want your font to say leading edge, progressive. You need to be sure you determine your final value propositions or unique brand assets. Make sure that you're in touch with those. And then look at the colors that you think you want to use and see what they mean subliminally. You need to do a lot of research to determine that, but see if they will resonate with your ideal target market. Because if you choose the wrong color, you really significantly decrease how your brand will resonate with your target markets. And mm-hmm. that's really limiting your business growth.
Right. On a side note, when we're talking about how all these colors are resonating with your target audience, how do the colors actually, do they have any effect on the people internally?
Yes, they do. They definitely do. They fortify the assets of the company that the employee or team member works for. They connect with those colors as well. The subliminal value of those colors is very universal.
Mm-hmm. Perfect. So they don't need different colors for internal and external.
No, and that would be the worst, that would be the worst thing you could yeah. do. Consistency in branding is key, both visually and verbally.
Perfect. Awesome. Well, Liz, this was wonderful. You had a ton of really great tips and tricks for people and a lot to think about with color. So if anyone wants some help in figuring out this process, how can they get in touch with you?
The best thing to do would be to email me at liz@mountainviewmarketingllc.com. You can call the office at 540-675-1201 or connect with me on LinkedIn. And I'd be happy to do a complimentary consultation.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Liz.
Thanks, Carrington.